and just put these in there. This will give you a background garlic. So you can take these and melt them in some olive oil, very low heat, medium low heat. Just melt them in there without browning them or crisping them at all, and it'll perfume your olive oil with a very subtle garlic background note. It kind of rounds aromas out. It gives you that earthy, rich, heady garlic aroma. Okay. If I took this and minced it, so then you take a paring knife, and I would come in there and go this way once, maybe twice, maybe the other one, and do micro garlic, and then you come by this way, and then you come across this way. You can get really perfectly minced garlic. So there's minced, and that'll give you a much stronger aroma in your garlic because it's more processed. Okay? Remember, we talked, if the more the garlic is processed, the more intense the flavor is going to be. There's two essential oils in there that when they rub together, that creates that garlic aroma. You have a little spot on there, just cut it out. How many of you do not like garlic? My wife can't stand too much garlic. She gets migraines. Triggers her. I'm so sorry for her. I cook a lot of garlic.
Honey, I'm cooking.
Okay, I'm going shopping. Bye. So if you want upfront garlic, intense garlic, you just cut it in half and make sure that's removed, and then just smash it like that. And you can see all the juice on there. That's it. And then you can even just take this and smear it back. And we'll get a lot of it. You can just smear it back and forth and make a paste out of it. And then take it and cut it up. And then your entire house will smell like garlic. Paste.
Now it would be the strongest.
This is the Rocky Balboa. That's strong stuff. So that's how you kind of either slice, mince, or schmear, make a paste out of the garlic. Okay. And rinse this off real quick.